The world's first pig heart transplant surgery has not gone very well. In today's Face to Facts Friday video, we'll take a look at what happened, as well as some other interesting stories at the end of the video. I'll be responding to some of the dumbest comments I've seen this week, so stick around for that. How old are you, 12? Oh, you? No, I'm 32, mate, but yeah, I know I look really young. It's the veganism. Thanks though, man. Let me know you're ready to start the video by hitting the like button right now. Let's talk about this pig heart transplant situation. The world's first pig heart transplant surgery went ahead in January. They bred a genetically modified pig, killed the pig to put that pig's heart in this man. A man who in the past stabbed another man so many times that he paralyzed that man for life. Sounds like he really deserved that new heart. Well, that doesn't matter anymore because now, 2 months later, the world's first pig heart transplant patient has died. They've not revealed how he died yet, but it probably had something to do with him having a fucking pig's heart in his body. I guess at the end of the day, the pig got the last laugh. You know that pig was just sat around eating piles of junk food and smoking 50 cigarettes a day, sneaking out and guzzling down as many liters of highly processed oil as possible as a big fuck you to the guy who was gonna get his heart. You're gonna take my heart? Fine. But I'll make sure it's 10 times worse than the one you already have. That pig's just sat there in pig heaven now, like, yeah, that's what you get, you fucking heart thief. In most other situations, calling someone a heart thief would be romantic. Apart from a situation where you're literally ripping out their heart to save the life of some old criminal. I know, you shouldn't speak ill of the dead, I know, but how else am I supposed to make jokes if I don't? I'll deal with God when I get up there, I'm sure he'll agree, jokes come first. The way things are going right now, they'll probably say he died of COVID. Gotta keep these death figures high, otherwise people are gonna end up feeling comfortable going outside and living their lives again. We can't have that. Pig heart transplant patient dies? COVID. Car crash victim? COVID. Respiratory failure? Definitely COVID. Yeah, okay, that last one was probably COVID, to be fair. What? What do you mean COVID's not a thing anymore? What do you mean it's all about Russia and Ukraine now and COVID pretty much doesn't exist? Really? No, okay. It's Putin's fault he died. Somehow. And you need to boycott something. Do you know what the real cause of this guy's health problems were, though? He wasn't eating enough meat. If he'd just eaten enough meat, he definitely would have lived longer. Sorry, vegans, it's true. We've been fooled. It turns out meat is actually magical. Not that cool Doctor Strange magic. We're talking Christian Old Testament animal sacrifice magic. Apparently, if you chant the words, Joe Rogan, give me the power of the elk, as you're killing an animal, when you eat that dead animal's body, its life energy will transfer to you and you'll live longer. Honestly, that's more believable than this new study. These guys are claiming eating meat makes you live longer. All the science that says less meat is healthier is wrong. The hospitals aren't full of meat eaters dying of diet-related disease. They're packed with vegans. The meat eaters are all outside, chomping down on Big Macs while running marathons and enjoying that meat extended life. Mike the Vegan did a thorough takedown of this study. His video is pretty sciencey though, so if you're not into that, let me give you a quick breakdown of why this study is bullshit. So in summary, the study's bullshit.
It's false. No way. Not this time. It's totally made up. Pure fiction. It's fiction. It's fiction. It's a made-up tale. It's a total fabrication. It never happened. It never happened. This one was invented by a writer. Not this time. It never happened. It's false. It's a fake. It's fiction. It's an urban legend that never happened. It never happened. It never happened. It's fiction. It never happened.
There you go, that's the breakdown. Seriously, one of their findings was that obesity was linked with a longer life. The study was full of biased, opinionated, pro-meat ideological comments. The authors have even been interviewed by pro-meat publications giving loads of cringe pro-meat comments based on nothing but their opinions. I think the question they were really trying to answer with this research was, how do we get on the Joe Rogan podcast? They're going after that big meat money. Have you noticed how many scientists and doctors are so desperate to become celebrities these days? These pro-meat numpties would probably start an OnlyFans where they just sit there naked, rubbing meat all over themselves while talking about the benefits of eating meat if it meant they could get a bit of fame. Shit, did I just give Sperridge a great idea? A different study was published recently by a more respectable organization with better data, and guess what? Yeah, you guessed it. It also says eating meat makes you live longer. Obviously, I'm kidding. It says the complete opposite. That eating meat lowers your life expectancy and eating whole grains increases it. Who knew? Apart from every respectable doctor and scientist in the world who actually looks at the data instead of desperately looking for excuses to eat meat because bacon though.
Fact.
But look, at the end of the day, these scientists are doing this in the name of health. They're just trying to save vegans from the troubles of beating the shit out of meat eaters in the boxing ring. Yeah, the plant-based world champion boxer Lawrence Okolie just defended his title against a meat-eating boxer. Ouch, meat eaters. What's going on here? Your boy just got got whooped by plants. It's almost like you can be healthy and strong without eating meat for protein, though. Who knew? Apart from every respectable doctor and scientist in the world who actually looks at the data instead of desperately looking for excuses to eat meat because bacon, though. At least the hyper-rich elite meat eaters are trying to do better for the animals. They found a better way to make foie gras, the food that's made by force-feeding geese until their organs almost explode, then slitting their throats so rich people can eat their livers. Instead, this foie gras farm lets the geese roam around eating acorns and olives before catching them and slitting their throats so rich people can eat their livers. That's way less serial killery.
A census taker once tried to test me. I ate his liver with some fava beans and a nice Chianti.
The Silence of the Lambs is an epic movie. Don't you just love watching a good movie at the cinema? The excitement of booking the tickets, the smell of popcorn when you walk in, the sense of satisfaction when you finally sever the head of a goat and smear their blood all over the movie poster. Wait, what?
You serious?
Yeah, a group of young Indian men celebrated the release of a new movie by decapitating a live goat and smearing their blood on the movie poster. Indians, listen, I love you guys. I spent a long time in your amazing country and I met some incredible people doing some incredible things, but you need to sort this shit out. How do you go from, oh my god, new movie, to I'm gonna chop off this animal's head?
That escalated quickly.
It jumped up a notch.
It did, didn't it?
I just hope this guy doesn't have an exciting life. Yes, I got that promotion. Just lunges for the knife, like, who do I stab? His wife has to hide the dog every time they have sex. His kids live in fear, terrified at what might happen if their dad wins the lottery. Apart from going on a stabbing spree, what would you do if you won the lottery? Prince Harry is richer than any lottery winner, and he decided to spend some of that money on going to see assholes abuse animals at a rodeo in Texas. Well, it just goes to show, you can take the boy out of the royal family, but you can't take the royal cunt out of the boy. We've got a few more interesting stories, then I'm going to respond to some of the dumbest comments I've had this week. If you're not a royal cunt, prove it right now by liking the video and subscribing to the channel. Integrity is hard to come by these days, with celebrity tools like Prince Harry getting all the attention, but there are a few shining examples in a world of shitheads. Like Alex Lengel, a vegan who recently walked off the popular TV show MasterChef because they asked him to cook meat. He put his principles before fame and fortune. You don't see much of that these days. This vegan who went on the British Bake Off, another popular TV show, and cooked animal products on the first fucking episode, could learn a thing or two from Alex. And while we're on the topic of women in the kitchen, this new article says the future of food is female. But I thought the whole idea of women being in the kitchen was bad, an agenda norm that we're trying to destroy with feminism and stuff. I think I speak for many men when I say, we're confused. Make your bloody mind up. By the way, this is a pretty interesting article about the Vegan Women's Summit. They're trying to help women succeed in the food tech industry, so go check it out. It's not just vegans empowering women. The dairy industry is all about gender equality too. Here's a now deleted tweet that the Canadian Dairy Commission made. We would like to take time today to celebrate the talented women in the Canadian dairy industry who forge change and empower others to do great things. It's great that in the West, women have bodily autonomy, freedom to live as they please with a legal system in place to protect them from discrimination and abuse. Let's celebrate all of that by encouraging women to take away the bodily autonomy and freedom of other female animals, discriminate against them, and abuse their bodies for profit. What next? Are they going to have a black woman chaining up elephants to celebrate Black History Month? Someone who recovered from an eating disorder starting a force-fed foie gras goose farm? A child abuse survivor starting a Joe Biden nursery school? To be fair, it's probably safer to have him run a nursery than run a fucking country, even with all the sniffing.
Thank you.
And from a sniffy Joe Biden to a shaky vegan, as this vegan shopper has been left shaken by finding out that some fruit isn't vegan. Surprised, sure, but shaken. She's having a nervous breakdown every time she sees milk powder in a packet of crisps. Panic attack when the muesli has honey in it. Welcome to veganism, bitch. Read those fucking ingredients. Fruit, well, some fruit isn't vegan. It's true. The numpties growing the fruit cover it in shellac. Shellac is made from lac bugs. They produce shellac to protect themselves. And apparently 25% of this shellac stuff you see in or on food is actually made up of crushed lac bugs that get caught in the processing. There's a bit of extra protein for you. Maybe try and grab your fruit from a local farmer. Make sure to ask them if they're covering them with dead bugs before you buy them, so you can tell them to add it if they're not, obviously. All right, guys, we've reached that time. It's time to respond to some of the dumbest comments I've had this week in our Meat Flakes of the Week. Imagine being this guy's friend. He's the type to go on a 30-minute rant for seeing someone eating a hot dog. Actually, no, that never happens. I don't have any friends. How to report your channel? All you gotta do is click the little like button, click the little subscribe button, and click the little notification bell as well. And that's how you can report me to YouTube. It's very simple. Trying to be over smart. It's better than trying to be under smart like you, Manav.
Meat is good. Bruh. This shit gotta be racially motivated.
Someone said an opinion I don't like. Quick, pull out the race card. Meat is absolutely delicious.
Okay.
Bro, it's the circle of life. We have to eat. Animals literally kill each other every day.
Circle of life, we have to eat. Animals kill each other. Bingo! Bingo!
You're funny and completely inaccurate. All the best. Oh, she said I'm funny. Vegan food tastes like shit. I think I'm gonna stick to McDonald's. If you're legit never ever gonna go vegan, then you should really eat as much McDonald's as possible. Like, eat it for every meal, like 3 times a day. You won't be much of a problem for anyone anymore. LMAO, how old are you? 12? Oh, you. No, I'm 32, mate. But yeah, I know I look really young. It's the veganism. Thanks though, man. Really appreciate that. I think your perception has to be heightened, silly fellow. I've been called a lot of things in my life, but this is too fucking far. Never ever call me a silly fellow ever again. Steak or a vegetable with supplements. Look, we've been through this a million times. I don't want to eat pieces of wood. I want to eat vegetables with supplements. You don't pay people to kill animals. That's not how it works. Totally true. Slaughter workers just work for free. They're doing it from the goodness of their hearts. Who knows how they pay bills? If meat is so disgusting and represents rape, murder, and torture, then why do vegans imitate it? Then I responded explaining that it's the same reason people play video games that are violent. They don't actually want to be violent. You get the pleasure from pretending, but you don't hurt anyone.
So vegans are just pretending to consume things that have been raped, murdered, and tortured. Got it.
Sometimes you wonder if they're genuinely that fucking dense or if it's an act. I really worry about people in these YouTube comments sometimes. I genuinely worry. The ultimate meat flake of this week is this pathetic troll in Toronto. Some vegan protesters went out and projected a message on the side of a building that said animal agriculture is killing our planet. Some meat flake little troll decided to project the word no under it.
Oh, really showed them vegans, didn't you, mate?
Make sure you get down in the comments and let me know what you thought of this week's Face to Facts Friday. And remember, keep calling out that bullshit. I'll see you all in the next video.